My name is Mira Furlan, and I'm here with the movie directed by Danis Tanovic, Cirkus Columbia. When Danis called me to play this role with my old friend and colleague Miki, with whom I did a movie 1,000 years ago, which was Kusturica's movie when father was away on business, which got a lot of acclaim and success and so on and so on. And when I read the script, which is one of the best scripts that I've read in many, many years, which deals with our past and with this region and with the beginning of the war and with the past in such an honest, sincere and human way, I was delighted. The role is beautiful. It's from my perspective as an actress and as a human being, it's a love story between two people who didn't see each other for 20 years, but still the connection is vivid and alive and there. I can connect with that story and with that view of that period so much because it happened to me. I'm one of those people who were thrown off guard, who were completely puzzled by what's happening, who didn't understand, who were completely unprepared for what was coming. And what was actually prepared by many people who worked very hard to prepare the war. We, ordinary citizens, me included, didn't know anything about it, couldn't understand anything, couldn't read the signs. You know, afterwards you think maybe we were not willing to read the signs. We were too afraid, we were too scared, and so on and so on. Innocence. In a way, yeah. I mean, you know, the signs, the reasons, the all that, the complications that led to this horror existed in this state of innocence. I mean, that also is a fact. But somehow we lived oblivious of all that. And maybe that's, you know, I always think maybe that's our guilt, you know, not understanding, not getting it, you know. I always think I didn't know where I lived, you know. I didn't know who those people were, who my audience was. And that's somehow why I left. I couldn't stand the nationalism. I'm not that person. I couldn't take it, couldn't be that. It's a very important movie in that way. Not only for Bosnia, for the whole region, you know, because the whole region deals with the same problems and things are easily and very quickly forgotten in this part of the world. There's no remembrance of the past, so we have to go back and see what happened and who did what and why. It's very important, otherwise there's no healing, there's no movement forward. The healing that we all need cannot happen. And in a way the war is, I can't say a background, because it's an essential part of the thing, you know, but it's about human beings and their little threads that connect them and disconnect them. And it's a great thing that you said, redemption, yeah, because the main character Divko redeems himself at the end, and that's how this love is shown, through very indirectly. It's a very subtle movie, I think. It has such subtlety. Nothing is shown in a way, but everything is felt. But I also want to say about the movie and about exploring the past and somehow, you know, exploring the reasons and all of that in order not to repeat the same mistakes and to understand and to take responsibility for what happened. The movie is important because it doesn't put the blame on any of the sides. It shows the complicated structure of life from which then this horror happened. You know, nothing is black and white. And the movie is wonderful in saying that, in depicting that, without any brainwashing. So I think it's very hard to do, because people are full of anger, and rightly so. You look up at the hills and you see the cemeteries. You wanna yell. You wanna hold. I mean, you know, how to forgive? How to get past that? And I know it from my own little life, where I was also blamed and treated as a traitor and so on, for not taking sides and for not being a part of war propaganda that I didn't want to. I just didn't want to have anything to do with that. So I know how hard it is to forgive, you know, and to move past. But these people have succeeded in doing that. I mean, most of all, more than anybody else in this whole region, you know. And they went through the greatest horror. They were surrounded with absolute evil, I can say. But they moved out of it with such grace and with such elegance and with such spirit. I bow to that, you know, and that's a lesson for me. All these years, you know, for me, being away from all this, but somehow staying who I am, you know, and not really, never could do what was required to do in order to stay here, so I left. And the price was very high in terms of my work, of my career, and so on and so on and so on. But it's worth it now, I think, you know, because there is real respect for that and real appreciation. And somehow there is the need in every region. I was working in Croatia for the first time after 20 years. You know, and I was in Dubrovnik, where I spent many, many years doing theater and so on and so on. I also did the Serbian movie and went to the opening night in Belgrade. I mean, I still believe that there is true possibility of some kind of life together, you know, in spite of everything that happened. I feel it, you know, in reactions of people and how they receive me and how they feel about it. I think people are so sick of this nationalist thing, which didn't bring us any good. I mean, it brought good things to a couple of people, you know, who stole a lot of money, you know, from the countries and the people, all of us. And people see it. It's there is a lie in this whole big, huge talk. I think people are sick of it, and people need normality, and they need the healing, you know, and I feel like I'm a part of that, and my coming here is a part of that process, and I'm so happy about it. It's magical, it's beautiful. I mean, the victory is unbelievable. You feel it. You're so proud of the fact that here in this spot, where the most horrible things have happened, this can happen now. It's really like a victory. Somebody said at a press conference, not somebody, but my friend and a man whom I respect so much, Haris Pašović, a wonderful theater director. He said, it's a victory over fascism. And I really, really feel that. And I'm so proud and happy.